A spirit alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I got a feeling. Oh, I am alive. There must be a reason. I was given one more chance. My heart's still beating.
Praise God.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
Sir, flex, I do work. Work six, I'm like Mike. He's out of sight.
So when I tell you guys that God came through for me, y'all, this is a prayer. You about to fly away. You about to fly away. Y'all, God really came through for me like he does all the time. And I just wanted to give somebody some hope and some encouragement right now, because the reason why God had me made all the videos that I made and displayed my struggle on my ministry is so that you guys can see that he's going to come through. I knew that he was going to come through. But when we are in the fire, it don't feel good, y'all. It don't feel good. And it was John. Is it 1 John? Or is it John 1? Something. But it's just saying, you know, count it all joy when you fall into various trials and tribulations, you know, because it produces patience. And when you let that patience produce in you, you know what I'm saying? Like, God's will can be done. And that's what was happening inside of me, y'all. Like, I had to be in the car. I still live in the car, you know, but I have my own car now. And so it's like, God is doing a new thing for each and every one of us. Like, none of us are excluded. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're really trying to live your life for God, if you're truly trying to live your life for Jesus Christ, you're a chosen one. He's not going to let you down. Y'all, this is a praise report. I was not myself, y'all. I was under so much heavy demonic oppression, y'all. Darkness, wickedness, making wicked decisions, doing stupid stuff, y'all. That was me just a few weeks ago, last week, a few days ago. And God delivered me yesterday morning. This is before I knew I was going to get the car. This is before this. Before all of this, I was telling God, I'm sorry. And like, Lord, your will be done. The whole nine, you know? And like, he is such a faithful God, because I was crying over stuff that I did. And he's like, why are you still bringing it up? God literally directly told me, and this is for you too. Why are you still bringing it up? I forgive you. And that's what he told me, like, y'all, we be condemning ourselves. We be bringing up the past. We be bringing up our wrong. You know what I'm saying? We can't take on that role. That's the role of the devil, the accuser. We can't sit here and accuse ourselves all day, every day, when God has already forgiven us. And that's what he's told me. Everything that we go through, y'all, is literally supposed to be that way so that his will can be done. I was supposed to be in the car. I was supposed to make these videos. I was supposed to let y'all see my struggle. You know how embarrassing, but yet humbling that was? I would never do nothing like that. God told me to make these videos. God told me to ask for help. God told me to get on camera and show my struggle. You know how humbling that was? I would never do nothing like that. That's got to be the command of God. I would never do nothing like that. Praise God. Praise God.
When I'm worried about tomorrow, I won't be overwhelmed, and the burdens that I've carried, I will choose to lay them down. 'Cause what I've learned about your favor, your mercy and your grace, is they go on forever. They're sufficient for today.
I'm telling y'all, if we can get sisters to stop working with each other and stop hating on each other.
God, I can't hear nobody. Stop being jealous. It ain't her fault she's cute. It ain't her fault she got that much anointing. It ain't that fault she's still working out every day. It ain't her fault. I need every sister to give another sister a high five and say, girl, I ain't jealous of you. I'm fighting for what you fighting for. I want to see you win. I want to see you get to your next level. I want to see you as more than a conqueror.
Become your best self. Become the person you dreamed about. Become who God created you to be. Become and live. I love you, friend, and God loves you most. Have a great day. Bye.
Wait on God. I know everybody is going faster, but wait on God. I know you have a plan B and you're ready to get to it, but wait on God, because when God does it, he does things, all things well. When God does it, you will owe no man. When God does it, you ain't got to pay nobody back. When God does it, he knows how to set the stage. When God does it, you ain't got to repeat the course. When God does it, he makes all things good. Wait on God. The Bible says, for I know you think you know. He says, but I know the thoughts and the plans that I have towards you. He said, and they are good. He says, to bring you into an expectant end. So wait on God. They that wait upon the Lord, he shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Wait on God. When you wait on God, God says, I know how to make it good. When you wait on God, God says, I know how to put you in the place of promise. He says, I know it may be tough right now. It may be challenging right now, but wait on God. Just put it at the bottom of the screen. I will wait.
Get up and do what you have to, because you never know when your next opportunity is going to come through.
Hear me when I say this. Listen, they didn't think that you would bounce back from that hurt that they caused you on purpose. You feel me? They didn't know that you adopted the pain as an antidote to minister to your wounds. Everything that they have done to you out of spite has helped you rip back your weakness and expose that strength your spirit's been looking for. Is you following? That's why they're shocked. Because this image that you hold now, this pressure that you're bringing behind your ambition, it brings them to a shame. So much to a shame that they're ready to jump in the grave that they dug for you. Be to God, man. Being your enemy is the last thing that they want now that they see the God in you. You feel me? Keep allowing your presence to speak for you, because it's going to be hard to do as you eat.
Listen, you wasting your time. Stop worrying about who isn't supporting you, who hating on you, all of this really elementary stuff. And just do you. Write the post, start the video, start the channel, start the job, start the business, whatever it is. And God is going to send you people who don't know you, because they're going to support you anyway. But it's time to stop singing that sad song and move forward and pray for them, because if they knew better, they'd do better.
Hello to my queens, my kings out there. I have had a lot of inboxes, so I want to talk about this. When it comes down to relationships and different things like that, it's a lot of people that are single and desire to have somebody in their life. I want to say to those single folk, we all have been through heartbreak. Whether you're young, whether you're older, we all have experienced heartbreak. We all have been in the moment of being heartbroken, or either been with someone that just wasn't ready. You got to put it like this. Okay, learn to understand that everybody is not meant to be your rightful mate. Okay, you have to accept the fact that that person is not ready for a serious relationship when it comes down to being in doing kingdom business. You have a lot of people still want the streets, and you have to allow those people to stay in the streets, and you keep moving on. If somebody that you like, or you know, they may talk a good game, but if they are separating you from doing what thus says the Lord over your life, that person is not meant to be with you, okay? And we have to learn to accept quickly that everybody that we meet are not husband and wife material. Some people take a while to get to that point. So don't waste your time and waste your life trying to help a person get better, okay? They have to want to be better. They have to want to be successful in a relationship. A relationship takes work. It's nothing perfect by any relationship. I don't care if people are happy in their marriage or happy in their relationship. This still takes work. It takes communication. It takes consistency. It takes wanting each other. You have to want each other. And if that person doesn't want God and you're trying to make them want God, it's not going to work. I shouldn't have to make you and make you have a relationship with God. You should already have one. Because if you already have a relationship with God, then you will know how to treat me as a woman of God. And I would know how to treat you as a man of God. It works hand in hand. Because one thing about God, he teaches and educates his kids. Okay? That's why relationships take work. Okay? You're going to go through different seasons in your life where you're going to have to communicate. You may disagree, but you don't have to disrespect each other. Okay? You can respect each other and disagree. You can love each other and disagree. So, again, to the ladies and to the men that have experienced heartbreak, put God first in your life and allow God to send you that rightful person. And if they are separating you, they are not the one. God bless.
Perfected Faces done by Candy 242-395-0125.
The most beautiful things in life are simple yet wholesome. The idea of beauty, I believe, got eroded gradually. Thanks to media and pop culture, what was once beautiful is now called shabby minus. Unkempt hair, freckled face, fat thighs, hairy legs and armpits, stretch marks and cellulite. When the models on the billboards and magazines are just like you and I, behind those numerous filters, we deem to be perfect. Perfected Faces makeup artist Candy Cumsey